So I can praise the Lord. It was 33 years ago, 11 months and 22 days that I received the Holy Spirit. It was January 1st of 1990. The Lord gave me a nice, easy day to calculate and remember. I'd been baptized by full immersion the week before that. And life in the Lord is very interesting. Life in general has ups and downs, and whatever happens to people in the world happens to us. I fellowshiped in Victoria for a number of years. Was laid off twice, lost the job when one company went bankrupt. And in the 8 years I was there, I had 17 jobs. Now, some of that's not fair, because counting a job when you're only there for a week on a temp assignment isn't fair, but be it as it may, I had 17 jobs in Victoria. And things didn't work out well, so I moved to Fresno. And within 2 weeks of moving to Fresno, I landed a job. I worked for that company for 24 years, and then two weeks ago today, I was informed at 9:30 that my position had been eliminated, along with about 150 other positions, and that my access would be cut off at the end of the phone call. And it was bonk. So life keeps happening. The Lord is in that job. I learned a bunch of new skills and a bunch of experience. But be that as it may, I've got a lot to offer on the employment, but I'm still unemployed today. And in one sense, it's kind of scary, being on the age spectrum where I'm at and looking for a new job. But on another sense, it's really exciting to know that the Lord is looking after me, and he's looked after me before. And I just have complete trust and faith that the Lord will continue to look after me. And whatever the next step is going to be a blessing from the Lord. And there's going to be more hard times, more rough patches, more bad things are going to happen. But there's a lot of good things happening too. Up here in Seattle, fellowshipping with you folks. I have a whole new fellowship that showed up in Vancouver a couple of years ago. And it's just amazing how keeping in the Lord and putting aside all those bad things that happen, putting aside all the stupid things that we do. Can I say stupid here? Because people are people and people do stupid things, and I'm a people, so there. I'm just really looking forward to the next step of what's going to happen. But what I'm really looking forward to is the day when Jesus Christ returns through the clouds and takes us home, because this world, every time I feel that some place is feeling like home, something happens, like I lose my job or other things that have happened, which I won't mention. But, you know, this world has never been comfortable, and don't think it ever will be. And I'm looking forward to my eternal home. Amen.